Goodness knows what we spend on our gardens, but there are gardens which are actually helping to raise money, not for their owners, but for retired nurses. The National Garden Scheme started in 1927 in memory of Queen Alexandra, who of course was very involved with the nursing profession. 1,300 gardens are now open to the public each year, and the proceeds go to nursing charities. Yesterday, many of them opened their doors for the start of the season. Looking through the list, one garden caught our eye, and Simon went down to investigate.
It may be hard to believe, but at the end of this council estate is one of the most beautiful gardens in Kent. And Kent, obviously, one of the most picturesque counties in England. Not far from Chatham, about 3 miles away. It's owned by George and Sis Olson, and Sis is really the driving force behind it. She opened it to the public for the first time yesterday, and it was a roaring success, and hopefully Sis is going to show me around. Sis? Sis?
Oh, hello.
Afternoon. How's it going?
Oh, fine.
Morning, George.
All right.
What was yesterday like then? Because you had a lot of people, I gather.
Oh, yes, we had 213. So that was fantastic, wasn't it?
In one afternoon?
In one afternoon, yes. So that was real good for the cause, wasn't it?
I bet. Yeah, but it must have created havoc in a place like this.
Well, no. Well, I didn't see much of it. I was walking around the garden, talking to everybody, and they had the run of the house. They had their tea and wandered in and out. So,
tea as well?
Oh, yeah. Well, that was 5p.
Right.
But they thoroughly enjoyed it and had to sit down. And if some had come quite a little way, you know, Deal and Wendover way.
Great. Well, we've come here to see the garden, so show me around, please.
Surely.
Great. Ah, Sis, looks great.
Yes, it's quite nice, really.
It's a bit blustery and wet today, but it still looks pretty good. What was it like yesterday?
Oh, it was fantastic. We had a marvellous day.
I bet you did.
Plenty of people. We were quite enthusiastic about them.
How much did it cost to come in?
20p and 5p cup of tea. They were ready for that by the time they'd walked round, you know, and they'd walked from different places.
Tell me how it started. How did your interest in gardening start?
Oh, well, I don't really know. It's just a thing that comes, you know, you have your house and then you think, well, I must keep the garden tidy. And
yeah, but it's a long way from keeping the garden tidy to getting something like this.
Well, I think you get greedy, you want a little bit more and you want it a little bit better and the ideas seem to be in your head and you go ahead and you do it.
Because you say you know nothing about gardening, don't you?
No, I don't. I'm a hit and a misser. I hope. Just put it in and hope it'll live. It doesn't always, but
but it seems, from what we've got here, that you've hit rather more than you've missed.
Yes, true. I do everything that's not according to the books, and it pays off.
How long have you been here?
18 years. 18 years now.
And what was it like when you first started?
Well, a building site. You know, it's just a load of rubble, you know, usual builder's rubble. And we've worked on it and stamped on it and carted the bricks. And
did you have any idea when you first came here that it was going to end up like this?
No, you can visualise. But I'm never satisfied. You see, one day I've got it to visualise like this, and the next, or perhaps next week, it'll be different. Something else will be in its place.
Because when you started, I gather, there was a story. You used to go up to the stables, which are around the back there, and nick some of their manure, didn't you?
Oh, yes, my two buckets all over the fields. Oh, 5:30 in the morning. A trip. It used to take 20 minutes to get from the top here and back. And then back again and back and back and back. About 3-4 hours I'd carry on doing that.
I bet they'd be interested to see what you've done here now, because it looks pretty spectacular.
Oh, yes, yes. Well, it's all been worthwhile. It's so heavy, the clay. You've got to have something to lighten up the soil. So.
That's helpful, is it?
Oh, yes, yes.
Right.
It's done the trick.
Certainly seems to have. Mm. Well, that's taking care of the history of the place. Now, I gather you've got some greenhouses here, haven't you?
Yeah, a couple of greenhouses and the conservatory.
Right, well, let's go and have a look. Come on. Right. So how long has this one been there, Sis?
Well, that one's been there now about 15 years. 14, 15 years.
It seems to be pretty packed out.
Oh, yes, but it's a bit different now to what it used to be. You know, when I first had it, we only had the one little flower pot sitting here, you know. And it looked absolutely lost. And I said, well, I'm never going to get that full up in all the rest of my life. But we've done so. And it's gradually filled and filled. Now I've got two in the conservatory, so we're quite happy. But my husband is talking about getting me another one.
Another greenhouse?
Another greenhouse, yes. So this one's rotting, actually. It's got a little bit of the woodworm or something down in the corner, so...
You're going to have to move soon, sis. You're getting too much.
Ah, yes, well, it's just a case of money. You see, we're... But I wouldn't mind moving. It would never worry me leaving things and starting all fresh again. That's,
was it mostly geraniums here?
Yes, a few bedding plants that we're going to bed out later on in the season, you know, end of May. But there's nothing like it should be. Everything so far, you know, behind, 3 weeks behind anyway, and I'd like to see things a little happier than what they are. They're not pleased with life at all.
Well, outside you've got some very pretty spring flowers, haven't you?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Well, let's go and have a look at some.
Mm-hmm.
Because they look lovely, sis. What's that, for example, sis?
Oh, that's a primula drumstick. I grew him from seed. It's quite pretty, isn't it?
Right. Here we've got tulips. I even understand those, even me.
Some
daffodils, yes, in the background.
A bit tattier. Mm. Yeah, they're pretty, too.
How many hours a day do you spend here, sis?
Oh, about 8, 9, 10. Depends on the weather.
You never get bored?
No. It's a pleasure.
What about George, though? What does he think?
Well, he doesn't say much at all. He knows where I am. He'll cut the bit of grass when I ask him, but he wouldn't do it until he goes, I swallow the grass and needs cutting, and out here come.
And he makes the tea, doesn't he?
Oh, he's a good tea boy. Makes a good cup of tea.
And he's enthusiastic about what you've done here.
Oh, yes, yes. He likes to sit in the deck chair and watch, weather permitting, you know, enjoy it.
Do you think you'll ever get professional like Percy Thrower?
Oh, dear, no. No, never that. Too old in the tooth, I think.
You might well have done, though, because...
I might have done years ago if I'd had the opportunity.
Yeah. Great. Well, sis, one thing I must ask you is about the neighbours. They must be really upset about you because you really do nothing for them.
Well, no, but they know I'm a crank, so what's the odds?
Sis, thanks very much for joining us. It's been marvellous.
Oh, thank you.
Back to the studio.